Good afternoon. Thank you for joining me, Pastor Zach Williams, for another edition of New Horizons, the daily podcast and radio ministry of Flat Creek Baptist Church here in Gainesville, Georgia. It is my greatest desire to dive deep into God's Word with you on a daily basis and to just see what God has to say to us today. If you would like more information about Flat Creek Baptist Church, how you can come alongside of us, how we can come alongside of you, when our worship services are, what ministries we offer, and even how to give to New Horizons so that we can continue this podcast and radio ministry and reach the world with the gospel, please visit our website, flatcreekchurch.net. Let me say, if you decide to give to New Horizons, 100% of everything you give goes directly to this ministry. Some of you have already given, and I greatly appreciate that. It enables us to continue to stay on the radio, which is a great blessing for so many. Guys, listen, I really appreciate you joining me today as we continue to look at John 3:16. Yesterday, we just began looking at this wonderful verse of Scripture, what I like to call the gospel in a nutshell, John 3:16. I've said it many times. I said it yesterday. I'll say it again. If you had one verse of the Scriptures and no other verse, and this is the only one you had, you would have enough here to save a soul for all eternity. Because in this one verse, Jesus lays the gospel before us. It's such a beautiful verse. I have pored over this verse for many years. And I will tell you, dear brother and sister, this is the verse that saved my soul on November 19th, 2009. It was when I got a hold of this verse and God reminded me of His deep love for me through His Son, Jesus Christ. Friends, I've never been the same. And so as we go through this verse, as we pick this verse apart, it is certainly a great joy for me to talk about it. I don't have any tattoos on my body, but if I had a tattoo on my body somewhere, it would be John 3:16. I want the world to know that this gospel is unique and different than any other religion, any other message out there. For what other message or what other gospel or what other religion has this? For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Friends, those might be the deepest, most profound words ever spoken by man. And it was spoken by the Lord Jesus Christ 2,000 years ago. Yesterday, we looked at this first consideration. We looked at just the beginning, for God. Today, I want us to go just a little further, for God so loved the world. Now, the term there in the Greek for the word world is the word cosmos. And it actually means the earth and the inhabitants thereof. So it is the world. It's where we live. It's this place. And so from this very verse, we find that there is a distinct and unique plan by God for this world. We are unique from all creation. You know, friends, I've been watching the news here recently, and they talk about all these UFO files that are about to be released. Let me just say something to you. Just because a UFO is spotted or even corroborated by the United States military does not mean that it's an alien UFO. It's just an unidentified flying object. It could be a drone. It could be something from Russia for all we know. The reason I bring that up is to tell you that God created the earth, and He created the earth on the first day. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. He didn't create the stars and the other planets and all those things in the universe until what? Day four. This earth is unique to the heart of God. He has a plan of redemption in place for this earth. We humans are unique from anything created in all the universe. God has set the stage for redemption, has set the stage to play out His full plan of grace right here on this earth. For God so loved the world, for God so loved the cosmos, For God so loved the inhabited earth. Now, consider God's love. God's love. The word there in the Greek is the word agape, and it means this unconditional love of God. As a matter of fact, as you study Greek words, what you'll find is there are many different Greek words for love. There's eros, that's an erotic love between a husband and a wife. There's also phileo, that's a love between two brothers. But then there is this word agape. And here's what's so unique about this word. In writing the scriptures, the apostles actually, and those who wrote the New Testament, actually really kind of hijacked this term agape. It was a word for love in the Greek, but it wasn't a widely used love. So they kind of hijacked the term and said, this is the love of God. It is a love that far surpasses human understanding. It's a love that far surpasses human limitations. It is a love that only God can give. And it is described in human terms as an unconditional love. It's a love that's beyond our comprehension. Paul would write in Ephesians chapter 3, verse 17 through 19, I pray that you may be able to comprehend with all the saints what is the length and width, the height and depth of God's love, and to know the Messiah's love that surpasses understanding. When was the last time you stopped to consider how high, how deep, how long and how wide the love of God is? When was the last time you stopped for just a moment to consider how much He actually loves you? And He does. The Bible says God is love. His love is far, long, high, and deep, and His love is reaching out for you today. If you could write anything to describe God's love, what would you write? Well, there was an old gospel hymn writer who tried to do this. And I believe that in his third verse of this song, I think he said it about as plain as anybody could ever say it. Listen to what he says. He says, could we with ink the ocean fill, and were the skies of parchment made, were every stalk on earth a quill, and every man a scribe by trade, to write the love of God above would drain the ocean dry, nor could the scroll contain the whole, though stretched from sky to sky. Oh, love of God, how rich and pure, how measureless and strong, it shall forevermore endure the saints and angels' song. Friends, that's a great way to describe God's love. Paul would describe it in Romans chapter 5 like this. He would say, But God proves His own love for us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. God loves you. Somebody who's watching this today needs to hear that. God loves you. No matter what you've done, He loves you and desires a relationship with you. When was the last time you stopped for just a moment to consider God's love? Maybe take just a moment today to just sit at His feet and consider His love. May God bless you, and I'll see you next time on New Horizons.